Hi people, this is an instructional build video for the Red 1419 Free Axis CNC from banggood.com. I noticed there are a few instructional videos out there, but I couldn't see one with an English speaker, so some of you might find this useful. Now I'll also be posting a review video soon so you can see what I thought about the machine. Spoiler alert, I really, really like it. Please also consider subscribing if you like this video, as well as hitting the notification bell if you want to find out when I release new videos. And if you found it useful, hit the like button, or if you found it rubbish, hit the dislike button, it's all good. So, I just managed to talk through the entire unboxing. But that's the boring bit anyways, right? It's not 2012 anymore. Now I will say, this thing was extremely well packaged, all the parts were there and in good condition. The first thing I recommend you do is clear a nice space to build this thing, and lay out all the parts so you can see what you've got. It's pretty unlikely, but knowing that you're missing anything now will be better than finding out when you're halfway done. Now most of the tools you need to make the thing come with the machine. Some hex keys, two spanners for the collet. I highly recommend, however, that you also have to hand some pliers, some side cutters, and some decent ball end hex keys. And you can also get those all from banggood.com as well, I should add. I'll put links to where you can buy them in the video description below. You should probably also consider getting some cable ties. Also, if you have one, a fancy electric screwdriver like this is nice too, although none of yours would be as fancy as mine. I'm not hoping to teach anybody how to suck eggs here, but I thought I'd better mention some basic CNC theory, since I refer to the axis quite a lot. Now the x-axis controls the left and right, the y-axis forward and back, and the z-axis is where the spindle moves up and down. And this is how the machine moves the spindle around to cut what it needs to cut and where. Now that's all out of the way, let's start by connecting these motor couplers to the motor shafts with some grub screws. There are three motors in total, but we only need to do two for now for the X and Y axis. Any two are okay, they're all the same. Eventually these motors and couplers will connect to the lead screws, which will move the spindle around and make the machine do its thing. Pro tip, if you have any, I recommend switching out one of the grub screws to a flat-ended one, instead of these pointy end ones that they supply. The motor shaft has a flat bit, so it will grip so much better this way. The pointy ones are perfect for sitting on the threads of the lead screw, however. Now we're going to make the Z carriage. The handing is fairly unimportant here, I think. These pillow bearings need to be screwed onto these plates. Use the M4 8mm long screws, but don't tighten them up just yet. Thread the lead screw through the Z motor a little, so about 40mm pops out the other side. Then add the manual knob with two grub screws. The pointy ones are fine here. Then use some M3 9mm long screws for the shaft motor to the X carriage top plate. Well, so you know, I'm going to be coming up with some random names for these parts that I think best fit. It should be clear from the parts that I'm using and the names that I'm using, but please, if you get stuck, let me know in the comments and I'll do my best to try and help. Note that here the lead screw should line up with the holes properly, and the plate should be the right way around with the holes facing outward. Attach the lead screw nut to the plate where there's an obvious hole for it with M3 12mm screws. You'll only need two of these, as just two of the holes seem to be tapped. Make sure it's facing in the same direction as the pillow bearings. Pop the spring on, and then add the other half of the anti-backlash nut and thread it onto it and push it down tight. Using M5 20mm screws, add the aluminium extrusion support plate to the plate where the anti-backlash nut is. Put the other Z plate against the other side of the extrusion so the pillow bearings are facing each other, and then add two more M5 20mm screws on the other side. Slide in short stainless steel rods, making sure they are free moving down into the top plate, and then screwed in with two M5 14mm screws. Move the carriage to the full extent so it's right up against the motor plate, and then tighten up all the bearings you can, pull the carriage back, and then tighten up the rest. Now mount the longer aluminium extrusion to the motor plate with two M5 14mm screws. Ensure the screws go all the way in and are not sticking out. The X carriage. Arrange the plates so they're the right way around, and add four pillow bearings with M4 8mm screws, four per bearing, making sure they are not fully tightened just yet. Attach a lead screw nut to the plate where there's an obvious hole for it, and then just as before, use two M3 12mm screws, making sure the nut is facing the same direction as the pillow bearings.
Using 4 and 5 20mm screws, bolt the plate with the anti-backlash nut to the side of the Z carriage so the pillow bearings face inwards. Pop the spring on and add the other half of the anti-backlash nut, thread onto it, and then push down tight. Mount the other X carriage plate to the other side with the bearings facing inward using another 4 M5 20mm screws to screw it into place. Slide the medium-sized steel shafts into place and tighten the pillow bearing screws once the shafts easily slide through them. Put in one of the circular bearings, I think it's a 608 in fact, into the bottom X carriage plate opposite side to the motor, making sure that there's a recess for the screw holes to be got at. And add the bottom plate to the Z carriage side plates and aluminium plate using 4 M4 14mm screws. And that's the Z carriage more or less complete. The bed. Take the front and rear bed plates and add the feet with the M4 14mm long screws. Then, with some M3 9mm long screws, add the last motor to the rear bed plate and ensure it is fitted the right way around. The Y carriage gantry. Fit the pillow bearings slightly loose using M4 8mm long screws, ensuring they are the correct way around. Fit the anti-backlash nut like you have done with the others, so use two M3 12mm long screws, and insert the rod from behind, fitting the spring from the other side, along with the other half of the nut onto the screw. Using M5 14mm screws, fit the two small pieces of double extrusion facing the same way as the pillow bearings, with the screws on each side. Fit the other side of the Y carriage using four more of the same screws. Insert the two pieces of short single width extrusion with more M5 14mm long screws, ensuring the holes face the right direction, facing away from the centre. Then it's fitting the Y gantry base to the bed assembly. With 4 M6 14mm screws, place the Y carriage into the bed and screw the lead screw into the coupler, making sure it's the right way around. Again, a flat grub screw is helpful here on one side. Slide the rods into the pillow bearings and secure the pillow bearings tightly. Using M5 14mm screws again, secure the rods into the rear plate of the bed. The front plate of the bed can then be placed on with the feet orientated the same way as the rear plate and the rods screwed in with M5 14mm screws again. You can then screw up the front plate into the aluminium extrusion with more M6 14mm screws, then tighten up those pillow bearings from earlier on the Y gantry. Using 4 M3 9mm screws, fit the stepper motor onto the side plate. It should be obvious which way around here, hopefully, and fit the coupler onto the stepper motor, if you haven't already. Ensure the cables orientate the correct way. Mount to the left side of the gantry base plate using M5 14mm screws on the two outer holes, and the two inner holes use M5 20mm long screws. Two smooth rods can then be fitted to the side plate using, again, M5 14mm screws. Probably got none of these left by now. The Z carriage can then carefully slide onto the rods, and one of those pointy grub screws can then fit onto the lead screw. Using three M5 14mm screws, mount what is hopefully your last piece of aluminium extrusion onto the side plate. Slide extrusion T-nuts into the extrusion for mounting stuff, two of them at least, but you may want to consider more if you've got some spare, just in case you want to add additional bits later. Fit the remaining side plate to the other side. Three M5 14mm screws in the extrusion and at the base plate as the same as the other side, and M5 14mm screws for the outer holes, and M5 20mm screws for the inner holes. Make sure you get these the right way around. M5 14mm screws to fit the rods as before. The round bearing goes into the hole around the threaded rod, and the knob goes on the end using the pointy grub screws again. Loosely fit M4 8mm screws and nuts to fit the first half of the spindle bracket to the extrusion. Slide it on, make sure it is central, and then tighten the screws up. And now pop in the spindle, making sure the socket is on the right hand side, and secure it with the other part of the spindle bracket and tighten it up so the spindle does not move. The supplied spindle was okay, probably about 150 watts or so, and it'll do 7,000 RPM, which is enough for the little operations you would do on a machine this size, but I may consider swapping it out for a 500 watt spindle that I also got from Banggood. If you also want to do something like this, make sure you run the power separately, as the controller board probably won't take much higher than the spindle that's supplied. You don't want to add a bit just yet, as you risk scratching yourself during the build. But just to show you how easy it is, just loosen the collet with the supplied little spanners, slide the bit in, and then re-tighten. The spindle will take 3.1mm bits with the supplied collet, but you can always switch out the collet. They're standard ER11 collets, and they'll take a few other sizes, but I probably wouldn't go much bigger with a machine of this size. Banggood do sell replacement collets and a good range of bits, which I do recommend, so I'll put links to those in the video description below. The control board, using M4 12mm screws, fit the electronics board to the rear plate on the Y gantry at the back. Try to make sure the sockets for the motors are at the top, with the power on the left. The control board that it comes with is pretty industry standard, so if you really wanted, it could be swapped out with a different one, and the Gerber firmware comes preloaded, so this could be upgraded or reconfigured to your heart's content. Although I can't see why you'd want to do this, because it's pretty fully featured for the price, allowing things like a controller and limit switches to be added, which is cool, so loads of upgrade possibilities here, including adding a laser. In fact, there is a version of this machine that comes with a laser module, or it's something you can purchase separately. Rather handy if you're low on space and don't have room for a little laser cutter like myself. Wire up the motors as shown, the sockets are labelled, and the connectors only go in one way around, so it's really hard to get wrong. There are, however, two sockets for the Y-axis, just to throw you. So be sure to get the right one here, it's labelled Y1. The spindle can then be wired up too. The supplied spiral wrap can be used to bind most of the cables together, and the cable ties keep all the cables tidied out of the way, but make sure there is enough length for everything to move and not tug on the cables. There should also be some cable protecting strips supplied that can be used to put the cable down securely into some of the slots in the aluminium extrusion. USB socket can be connected to the PC and the power socket to the supplied power adapter. Note that this is also your speed controller, so you can set it from 12 volts to 24 volts depending on how fast you want the spindle to rotate. The plug it comes with is the fairly standard plug of death that gets supplied with anything that you seem to buy from China these days, so I recommend that you throw this away and use a better, safer one. The last thing you want to add are your clamps. You get some cheapy cheerful ones with this machine, but you should really consider buying some T-nuts and making your own. And Banggood also sell a precision clamp, which you can see here, which is perfect for mounting little things really securely. So all the software you need to run the thing comes on this little CD. I'll also pop a link to where you can download the software as well, just in case you can't read CDs. It's easy to install and to get going with the Gerber software, although you can use other control software if you wish. There's a ton of resources out there for running a little machine like this, but I have considered making a quick getting started video. If this is something you'd like to see, please let me know in the comments.
And she's complete. Yes, mine is a girl, and I've named her Roxanne. Isn't she beautiful? I think so, which is why I've probably spent too much time taking fancy glamour shots of her. If you've also named yours, I'd really appreciate you letting me know in the comments below, purely so I don't think I'm going mad. In fact, any feedback you want to give in those comments is always welcome, even if you just want to say hi.